गेलो जाना पैसे जास्त तो बुझ पैसे ना जास्त एक पाँच सौ टाक दिए तुम
So good morning students, today I again start the chapter 8, that is atoms and molecules. So this is the important chapter, so I again repeat this chapter, and also you know that this is the last chapter in your syllabus up to midterm. So I request all of you that you must learn this chapter very carefully. Yesterday I asked some questions in this in my class, so few students all of you give me a wrong answer. Only Manan Chabra give me right answer, but I hope that all of you read yesterday in your home this chapter. So again I tell you and also I request to all of you that must learn this chapter very carefully. If you have any problem or any doubt, please ask me. So today I start here also atoms and molecules. At first I tell you what is molecule, that is in the chapter 7. All matter is made up of tiny particles, very thin particles called molecules. All matter is made up of very small or tiny, whatever you want to say, particles. It is called a molecules. So example is a molecule of oxygen has all properties of oxygen. A molecule of oxygen has all properties of oxygen. Okay. Now I give you a example which show you. Let's think this is a pen, but I think suppose this is a molecule of oxygen. It is, let's think that it is a molecule of oxygen. So part whole part it is a very tiny, but we touch it. Let's think that this is a very small particles. Okay, so this is the particle, this is the matter of molecules of oxygen. Okay, now come to the chapter 8. So why does this shape of the tip of the carrying change when you color a picture? It is because this shows that carnelian is very particle. I do not tell you this. I start from here. So these particles we see are not the smallest particles of a substance. In fact, all these substances are made up of thin particles that cannot be seen with our naked eyes. These particles are called atoms or molecules. So this particle is called atoms or molecules. Okay, now atoms. So an atom is the smallest particle of substance. An atom is the smallest particle of substance which cannot be broken by any chemical means. So I tell this is, let's think this is a molecule. If we broke this, that is we open the pen, we get two part. So in the previous chapter I tell you, if we broke the molecule, we get two or more than two, but we take two particles. So full pen is at molecules. After then we broke this, we get two particles. So this particle is the very small substance which cannot be broken. This is by chemical means. So it is the very these two particles are called atoms. Okay. So again, molecules. So carefully observe the crystal of salt, sugar, with the help of magnifying glass. For what do you see? Now they have very thin particles. These particles are called molecules. They make up a substance. So all molecules of a substance are alike, but molecules of two different substances cannot be alike. Molecule of one substance are different from the molecules of another substance. For example, molecules that make up a chalk are all alike, but there are different from those of the molecules of sugar or salt. It is because chalk is made up only one kind of element. On the other hand, salt or sugar is made up of two or more than two elements. Hydrogen, oxygen, iron, copper are the etc. are elements. So these two, I take two pen, I look this pen, it is the same. Its properties are same. If we mix this pen, so these two pens are different in properties. So if we mix these elements, these two pens, they create a new properties of pen. Okay. So more about molecules. Now molecules are made up of very thin particles called atoms. Molecules are made up very thin particles called atoms. So every molecules has one or more atoms. For example, each molecule of oxygen contains two atoms of oxygen. This is written as O2. So molecules of oxygen is one. Here oxygen is only one, but these molecules, let's think, this is a molecule of oxygen. This is a molecule of oxygen. If we broke, we get two molecules. One molecule if we broken, we get two atoms. So these two are atoms. So what we tell now, this is O2. Here molecules are only one, that is one molecule. If we broke, we get two particles, that is how many? Two oxygen atoms. Same nitrogen, we also written as N2, as same. But when atoms of different kind combined compounds are formed, for example, molecules of water H2O and carbon dioxide CO2 are made of different kinds of atoms. Yes, here you look, water means H2O. Here what are the compounds? Now one compound is H, that is hydrogen, and another is O, that is oxygen. So two compounds, what are they? Now the two compounds are, one is hydrogen and another is oxygen. So how many this is the only one molecule. Okay, now tell me that how, what are the atoms are? If we broke the H2O, we get H and O. How many H we got? We got 2H, that means 2 hydrogen. Okay, that means 2 hydrogen, and we got only 1 oxygen. So 2 molecules, what we got? Now 2 hydrogen and only 1 oxygen. Same kind, carbon dioxide. Here you look, what are the elements? Now elements are carbon and another is oxygen. Elements are carbon and another is oxygen. So how many carbon we got? We get only one carbon and oxygen, two oxygen. Okay, we got only one carbon and oxygen is two. Let's draw a picture. Come to the picture. Look at this. Here H2O. Look at 2H and one is oxygen. 2H means two hydrogen and one is oxygen. Okay, we draw this picture. If you got a question in exam that draw a molecule, draw a graph or draw a picture or draw a structure of a water, so what you need at first, if you tell that draw a picture of one molecule water, so that time you need to write the symbol of one molecule of water is written as H2O. What you write, one molecule of water is written as H2O, then you need to draw this structure. Okay, same kind, if you got the draw a picture or draw a structure of carbon dioxide of one molecule of carbon dioxide, so that time you need to write one molecule of carbon dioxide is written as CO2. One molecule of carbon dioxide is written as CO2. Here this carbon dioxide need to write spelling carbon here carbon dioxide, then you need to draw this picture. CO is only one and two oxygen. Okay, same kind which I draw yesterday, that is, look at this nitrogen in N2O nitrogen dioxide. If you got this question, you need to write one molecule of nitrogen dioxide is written as N2O. After then draw, here N is 2 and oxygen is O. N means nitrogen and O means oxygen. Okay, if you got two molecule of water, what you write? If you give question that draw a structure of two molecule of water, so that time you need to write two molecule of water is written as 2H2O or two carbon dioxide, 2CO2, then you draw this structure. Okay, now Ans, tell me, Ans, Sangam, all of you, tell me what you think up to this. Is clear this problem or any doubt? Rajmondal, any problem? Ans, give reply. Oindril, 1C and 2O, what you write? Yes. Okay, I know that all of you must read this chapter 7 and chapter 8. I request to all of you, please read this two chapters. If you have any problem, any doubt, so tell me in the time of teaching period. When you tell me, what is your problem? okay, okay, then I go to start solid and solution. Now come to the another part is solid. So tell me, what is solid? What is the solid? Now object which had to form and have a clear shape are called solid. Which particle or which element or which object are hard or firm and have a clear shape are called solid. Windrill, please do not write in small letter. H2O, H is, don't write this type. So H2 means only write H in capital letter. All of you, I tell you, if you got H, if you write this small letter H or O or N or C, I cut this number, I don't give this. So always remember, when you write these types of chemical structure or chemical name, whatever may be, always write, always use capital letter at first, okay? After then, in the higher class, you will know how we write, the process of the write. But you must, I tell you that you must write HOCO nitrogen, whatever may be, in capital letter, okay? Then Windrill, what you tell, that H2O has three atoms. Why three? Are you looking any three in before the H or before C? If you look that any three or two or four or whatever may be the number, you at that time you will look that this is the 3 or 2 or 4. If you cool is that, okay? But when you don't look any other any number is not written before the H, before the starting of the chemical symbol, that means only one molecule. Or whatever you look after H, after O, whatever may be in the suffix below H, so this is O, 2, this 2, this 3, this 4, this types of whatever this number is you find. So here means the number of atoms. If you look a 2 here, this means 2 hydrogen, but you don't look here, any number is not showing you. This means only one oxygen atoms, okay? If you look here 2, that means whole H2O is 2 molecule. Don't mix it, molecule and atoms. Molecules you will look before the number here. Stay, I draw a graph. Molecules means before the number, before the element, that is water, before the element, okay? If you look, if you look that here 3, that means 3 molecule of water. If you look, are you looking any number here? No, that means only one molecule of water. Okay, now come to the atom. What are you looking? That means two. This number is two. That means two hydrogen. Are you looking any number? No. Here comes. So this. How many hydrogen you look? That means two. If you look this here, this number, or here, this number, that means this is the how many atoms are present in the element. Okay, here what, how many hydrogen? That means if you broke this water, you got two hydrogen atom, two hydrogen atom and one oxygen atom. Okay, let's think another element, that is, it is the carbon dioxide. That means only one carbon dioxide you got. Only one carbon dioxide molecule. Only one carbon dioxide molecule. If you write here two, that means two carbon dioxide molecule. If you look here three, that means three carbon dioxide molecule. If you look the 32, that means 32 carbon dioxide molecule. Okay, then if I cut this number, then you broke this carbon dioxide. Sorry. So what you got? Now only one carbon. How many carbon you got? Only one carbon. How many carbon you got? Only one carbon. And how many oxygen you got? Not two oxygen atoms will go, you got two carbon atoms will got, only one carbon atom you got and only two oxygen atoms you got. Okay, another thing is N2O. That means only one nitrogen dioxide molecule you got. If you broken this, you will got two nitrogen atom. Here atoms are nitrogen and oxygen. Then you broke this, you will got two nitrogen atom and only one oxygen atoms. Okay, if you look here, the number is showing, or any number is not showing. If any number is not showing, that means only one atom is present in the whole molecule. If two present, that means two this element is present in the molecule. Okay, okay, now tell me if you had any question, any doubt. So now I ask some question. So at first, Wendil, you tell me SO4, here what are the elements? Now S and O. Here S means sulfur. So I do not give you this name. But think SO4, that means how many molecules are present? Wendil, tell me how many molecules are present in SO4. Wendil, tell me and answer. You tell how many oxygen atoms are present. How many ants tell how many oxygen atoms are present in SO4? Oindril tell how many molecules are present in SO4? And Sangam, you tell how many S atom are present. Okay, Sangam, give answer. S have one and O is four atom. Okay, Sangam, understand this. Okay, Hans, tell me, Hans, tell. Oindil, give me answer. Hans, Shreya, all of you give the answer quickly. Who are looking, give answer. I ask question, all of you please give me answer as soon as possible. That Sangam give the answer. Adup Roy, I do not ask you yes or no, give me only answer. Two atom, who two, what, how, who is the two atom, what is two? I don't know, Shristi Singh, why you don't know? What is your problem? Are you not understand what I am telling? Shristi Singh, if you have any problem, tell me. Shreya, now tell me how many molecule in SO4? Shreya, Jaiswara, tell me how many molecules in SO4? So, okay, no problem. Now give me the answer, Oindril. Why you give, all of you give answer four atom, what is the name molecule? Yes, Sangam, I know that you understand. Okay, you are good. Where the answer, what is the answer? I do not show you, please written answer. Again type the answer, Hans. I am waiting, after then I complete the class. Okay, Windil, you give the answer, but now tell me how many molecules you show. How many molecules are showing you? One molecule, okay. Sarna, please tell me. Okay. So now I think Oindril understand. Okay, Oindril, okay, good. All of you, I request this part, must learn this chapter because it is a very important chapter. I request to all of you, please learn this chapter very carefully. So tomorrow at 12 o'clock I will start the solid and solution again. Parthi, yes, molecules are one. After tell atoms, what are the atoms? One hydrogen, two oxygen, three iron. Raj Mandal, what are you typing? Okay, if you have any question, any doubt, you must tell me. Sarnapta, what is your problem? Why you are not participate? If you have any problem, tell me. Sarnapta Chakravarti, if you have any problem, so tell me. Tomorrow must learn this. Shreya, I tell which chapter are coming as soon as possible. okay, all of you, I tell this up to midterm, what is the midterm syllabus, I tell as soon as possible, okay. So don't take tension, it is my fault, I give all the syllabus, but must learn this chapter again and again. After complete this chapter, I will tell what is the midterm syllabus. So okay, so end of the today class, we will meet on tomorrow at 12 o'clock. Thank you.